In this illustration, we'll discuss about YDSE setup submerged in a liquid. Here, we are given that in a YDSE setup, a screen is placed at a distance 80 cm from a slit plane having slits S1 and S2. The separation of a slit is 2 mm. Here, we are given that the slit S1 is covered by a transparent sheet of thickness T1, which is 2.5 micrometer, and another slit is covered by a similar sheet of thickness T2, which is 1.25 micrometer. And refractive index of both of the sheet material is 1.4. And now water is filled between the slit plane and the screen, as we can see in this picture. Now it is saying, and a light of a wavelength 5000 angstrom is incident normally on the slit plane. And we are required to find the ratio of light intensity screen center C to the maximum intensity on a screen. And assume intensity of light on a screen due to both the slits are equal. So first thing here, we can simply write, if each slit produces intensity I0 on a screen, this implies the maximum value of intensity anywhere will be 4I0, wherever light will have a constructive interference. Now, we first need to calculate the intensity at C. So, we first calculate for this the path difference in lights from S1 to S2 to the screen center C. And for this, delta at C we can write as due to the first sheet of thickness T1, path difference introduced will be T1 multiplied by mu of sheet upon mu of water minus 1. Yeah, I'm taking the refractive index of sheet with respect to that of water. And the relation is the same what we have studied in concept videos, minus the path difference due to the second sheet, which is T2 multiplied by mu s by mu w minus 1. And this numerically becomes T1 minus T2 multiplied by mu s by mu w minus 1. And if we substitute the values, this is 2.5 micrometer and this 1.25 micrometer. So this 2.5 minus 1.25 is 1.25 into 10 to power minus 6 multiplied by mu s is 1.4 divided by 4 by 3 minus 1. When you calculate this value numerically, it comes out to be 1 by 16 into 10 to power minus 6 meter, which is the path difference at a screen center due to the light beams coming from the slits S1 and S2. Now, using this path difference, we can calculate the phase difference at C. Is this phase difference we can write as 2 pi by the wavelength of light inside the water or the liquid medium. We can write as lambda by mu water, because the light is eventually traveling in water and interfering here. So this multiplied by delta, if we substitute the values, this 2 pi by lambda is 5 into 10 to power minus 7 multiplied by mu of water, we can write as 4 by 3 multiplied by delta, here is 1 by 16 into 10 to power minus 6. So solving these values here, you can see the numerical phase difference we are getting is pi by 3. So as we have got the phase difference, we can calculate the intensity at a screen center is, intensity at a screen center we can write 4I0 cos square 5 by 2. So we substitute the values, this is 4I0 cos square, and the phase difference between the two waves arriving at C is pi by 3. So this will be cos square pi by 6. So, on substituting the value of cos pi by 6 and square it, this 3 by 4. So, the value we are getting is 3 I naught. So, here we can analyze the ratio of intensity at a screen center to maximum intensity will be given as this 3 I naught divided by 4 I naught, which is equals to 3 by 4. That is the result of this problem.